So let's talk about the iPhone zero click Wi-Fi exploit. Mm-hmm.
So a gentleman by the name of Ian Beer, he works for Google, and as part of the Google Project Zero, has posted a beautiful 30,000 plus word blog in which he details and then shows how easy it is to exploit an iPhone or an iPad because of a problem within the actual hardware. Now, he calls it a wormable radio proximity exploit. So wormable means that once one device is infected, it can in turn infect another device, and it can in turn infect another device. Radio proximity just means that it has to be close enough for the Wi-Fi to connect. And what he was able to demonstrate was that he could gain complete control over any iPhone in his vicinity, and there was no interaction. So usually when somebody gets a phishing email, there's a link they have to click on. Or if, you know, they get a pop-up on their screen that says, do you want to allow so-and-so to send you this file? Well, in this case, he didn't need to do anything like that. It gave him access to photos, email, private messages, monitoring everything that was happening on the iPhone in real time. Now, this issue was fixed in iOS 13.5. That was out in May of 2020. But the really great thing about Ian Beer's blog post is the amount of detail that he goes into. 30,000 plus words.
That's a long blog.
Mm-hmm. Labor of love.
Yeah. So perhaps we could take a step back and explain for some iPhone users who aren't aware of this feature in terms of the zero-click Wi-Fi, what it is for the iPhone.
In this case, this is what he's calling the exploit. But usually with iPhones, they want to make it easier for the end users. So, for example, I've seen it myself where I will try and connect to Wi-Fi using my iPad, and then my wife will go, do you want me to share the Wi-Fi password with you? I happen to have it, and my phone has popped up with it. So I don't actually have to click anything on my phone. She just says, I'll share it with Sean, and now my tablet automatically connects.
So I suppose it's a way, it's convenient, but also you don't know what the password is. You just, it has been shared with you.
Correct.
Interesting. Yeah, I've seen it once and it was really strange when it popped up, but that's an interesting feature for the iPhone. Okay, well, thank you.